And welcome back. And today I wanted to talk to you about a recent trip that we've done to Glasgow, and in particular to an exhibition at the Kelvingrove Museum and Art Gallery. The exhibition was Charles Rennie Mackintosh, Making the Glasgow Style. And that particular exhibition is in celebration of 150 years of his birth. And I've got to say, it was an exceptional exhibition. And if you like that style or want to know more about it, this is one not to be missed. It really is. I've often thought that in some of his designs, particularly in the chairs and the furniture, the squares and the rectangles are very reminiscent of his architectural drawings, particularly architectural drawings in planar view. There's lots of rectangles and squares, and it's very black and white. So I really think that influenced his work going forward. But that's my personal view. It's not just about Mackintosh, though. It's got all the big names that were around at the time. So the likes of Jessie M. King, the MacDonald sisters, obviously, George Logan, Tarwyn Morris, McNair, and more. So it covers not just paintings, it covers textiles, it covers furniture, wallpaper, books, ceramics, posters, magnificent full-size posters. So I was also pleased to see that Mackintosh actually did some abstract pictures. As you know, that's something I'm particularly interested in. And for one in particular, I did a sketch in my book. And it's lucky I did, because when I purchased the book for the exhibition, this was one of the few pieces that wasn't actually reproduced in this book. I think most of the other things that we saw there are actually in the book, but not that particular piece. So I guess there was some sort of copyright issue. But I picked up the essence of that, and I might use something along those lines, or at least be influenced going forwards. We shall see. So the book itself of the exhibition is really comprehensive, as I said. It's got everything in it, and in the centerfold, there is a centerfold, which I love, actually, because if I can open it at the right part for you. You have a centerfold, which for me is where it all began. So here, this is the May Queen by Margaret MacDonald Mackintosh, and it's, I think it's 1903 or thereabouts. And it looks very small here, but the original, the thing that we saw right up close and personal, is 4.5 meters wide by 1.5 meters high. And it's covered, well, not covered, but beads and thread and string and mother of pearl is applied to it. And actually, that's the piece from which my art started. That's what influenced me to start doing stuff and experimenting and doing things. So I just loved it to bits, and you get really close to this fantastic piece of work. The shop is good as well. I also purchased a glasses case, which is really nice. And what's extra special about it is that they've reproduced the imagery on the outside onto the cloth itself as well. So that's really, really good touch. So that's really lovely. You get all sorts as well. I also purchased at extraordinary cost one of the bags. Extraordinary cost, but you know, what the hell? I thought I needed something to carry some things about in, and it'd be the only time I'll get something like this, so I'm going to use it. So yeah, might as well with that one. But you've got everything you could possibly want there, including some extraordinary wallpaper at about £180 a roll or something like that. Thankfully, not to my taste anyway, but if it is your taste, maybe they'll have a sale, but that is quite exceptional. So we also went round the rest of the gallery a little bit, seeing the Scottish colourists, which is fantastic. And there happened to be an organ recital on, and we were having our lunch as well. So that was always a bit of fun to listen to, particularly when they, as it's now known, play the Monty Python's theme tune on the organ. So that's a bit of fun. And when we're in Glasgow, we always go to the art shops as well. There's some great art shops there. We didn't go to Miller's this time around. We didn't get a chance, but we did go to Cassart. And there Roy bought a set of Cobra art paints, water mixable oil colour, 10 tubes, and various accessories. So we just wanted to try those out, and we'll probably do a review a little bit later on. So really good art shop, really worth visiting that one. We also went to the Bead shop in Glasgow, and there is a sister bead shop in Edinburgh, but that's not quite as big as this one. This one has 4,000 square feet, and it makes it one of the biggest in the UK. I'm actually going to do a separate video about sourcing materials and beads a little bit later on, but you can spend hours in there, absolutely hours in there. And I bought lots and lots of lovely stuff, which I can share with you in a different video. We also went to the pen shop in the arcade, and there's lots and lots of fantastic shopping in Glasgow, of course. You can get around by the subway, which saves you lots of walking, and it's very reasonably priced. And as for if you're going to travel there by car and park up, the Buchanan Galleries or the Kelvingrove, or there's lots and lots and lots of other sets of parking that you can use, or go direct by train, which is another way of getting there, which is absolutely great. But in summary, from the exhibition, the Mackintosh making the Glasgow Style exhibition, really one to get to. It's on until the 14th of August 2018, so there's not a lot of time to get going and see that, but it is one that you really ought to see if you like that sort of thing. And I know we came away with so many ideas, so it's just absolutely brilliant. So enjoy, and see you next time, same time, same place.